kick it, Jackie Chan.
Hello and welcome to the first broadcast for 2019. I'm Sven Scott.
And I'm Douglas Arthur-Mensa.
You know, Douglas, I cannot believe it's 2019 already. I'm so excited for this new year and new semester.
You're right. We're only 1 month in and there's been so many changes.
Well, not only are students making progress, but adults in our community are trying to ensure that all students in Mason matter.
I actually sat down with the Diversity Council of Mason to see what their plans are for making Mason more inclusive.
Let's check it out.
We live in a fast-changing and increasingly diverse society. To meet our needs, the Diversity Council of Mason wants to promote inclusive excellence within our school and community. Public Information Officer and Diversity Council member Tracy Carson plans to work with students in 2019.
You know, the Diversity Council has been around for a long time, since 2004, actually. Community members, parents, staff came together, really as our district was growing in diversity. You know, working in the district, we have this incredible talent pool to tap into, and that's our community members. When we look around, we have people who have great experience, who represent so many facets of diversity, but also who have experience with education, higher education, with human resources, with communications. It's a blessing to be able to tap into those community members and get insights to help make our schools even stronger. And our Diversity Council members have shown time and time again that they're willing to be a sounding board, but they're also willing to roll up their sleeves and help make this a community that truly is celebrating authentic inclusion. One of the fantastic things that we have noted is that nothing helps center our Diversity Council's work better, and I would actually say even the district's work, than centering on our why, which is our learners. We have to hear our students' voices. And at Mason High School, there are so many groups who've been leading this charge and leading the way. You know, when I think of Mason Inclusion Club, our GSA, the you know, myriad student groups who are out there doing the work of actually building bridges, talking to each other about challenging issues, listening, just sitting back and going, that's an interesting perspective that I hadn't thought about. I think the grown-ups in our community, the adults who've been sitting here, need those student voices to help galvanize the work. And that is where our students have been incredibly helpful. I think in the future, there are events that we'd like to do with students as well. Some of the Diversity Council initiatives include putting together a celebration of Black history that we want students to be a part of. We're going to be launching a special art show and art exhibit and asking for student work and poetry that I think will be really important.
The Diversity Council of Mason is ready to achieve their goal of promoting inclusion throughout the school and the district. We cannot wait to see what else they have in store. I'm Douglas Arthur-Mensa, MBC News.
You can clearly see that the Diversity Council is putting in a lot of effort to make sure that minorities in Mason feel comfortable and celebrated.
Another group that's striving to make a change at Mason is the Mariah Michelle Foundation, who works with young girls to make sure they feel confident and empowered.
Reporter Judy Hugh has the story.
Oftentimes, putting your dreams into reality can be a tough process, especially when it comes to making a difference in society. However, one student here at MHS is prompting social change, one school at a time. Mariah Norman, currently a sophomore, was able to make her dreams become a reality when she created the Mariah Michelle Foundation.
Our organization is the Mariah Michelle Foundation, and basically what we do is we travel to different schools, churches, hospitals, inner city areas, and we teach these classes that empower the girls there and just teach a variety of topics that I would want to be taught to me while I was growing up.
What inspired you to start this organization?
Well, I'd always kind of wanted to start an organization where I empowered young girls, but it was kind of a bubble thought. But last October, after Maya Collins passed away, I definitely was more kickstarted to start it, and she was definitely an inspiration for it because she was such a positive, strong role model of what it meant to have girl power. And not only that, but like the topics that I teach in class are things that we had talked about or experienced together as friends. So she was definitely the inspiration just for the classes and me getting started and all of that.
Through her after-school programs, she hopes to empower young women and teach them important lessons of growing up female.
Currently, I work with Woodlawn and Glendale Elementary, which are both part of the Princeton City Schools District, and I'm also currently in contact with Springdale and one other school that we're still in the works for, so definitely we're trying to expand. So a typical session, I like to have people really engaged and active, so I always do games and activities, and I also like to foster healthy conversations, so I have a lot of discussion time where I ask the students or the girls like what they think about the question and they answer, or they talk in their small groups. The goal is definitely to take the whole idea of feminism and bring it down to a smaller scale that these girls can understand. So instead of talking about the wage gap, it's talking about like finding a seat to sit at lunch and just making sure that these girls feel empowered in this world that's kind of working against them. And I want them to be able to take away that they can do whatever they set their minds to and use these skills to really help in their like everyday life.
My favorite part about today was probably the M&M roulette because we got to learn stuff about people that like some things I didn't know about other people.
My favorite part of today is doing the Kahoot and learning about anti-bullying, social bullying, and cyberbullying.
Everything.
That was so fun.
All it takes is determination, a strong voice, and a kind heart to make a difference. And that's exactly what Mariah has done with hers. She hopes that other young women will be empowered to become better versions of themselves. I'm Judy Hu, MBC News.
It's really great to see students try and make a positive change here in Mason.
Speaking of change, Superintendent Jonathan Cooper announced a new change coming to all Mason City schools next year.
That's right. Though there has been talk about a potential time change for quite some time, students and staff have been very vocal about it for a while.
Having been met with many mixed reactions, Anna Knazowitz took it to the community to see how students, staff, and parents feel about this new time change.
After over a year of sleep studies, community input, budgeting deliberation, and the incredible task of trying to please everyone, a big change is coming to Mason schools. The 7:15 MHS and MMS start times have been a pressing concern by many students for many years. That's no longer the case as Superintendent Jonathan Cooper officially announces the start times for next school year.
So as you can see, as we make this announcement of moving the start time 30 minutes back, it has a rippling effect throughout the entire district. And so it's a really big deal, and we really take our mental health concerns seriously. And so that's why we're willing to look at changing everyone's schedule so that we can make sure that our high school students and our middle school students have a better start time that aligns with research, that gives an environment that's better for mental health and it's better for our students.
Regardless of what changes are made, administration always realizes that they can't give everyone what they want. Now that the change is finally here, MHS students are faced with the reality of how it could affect their day.
So I think that probably in the beginning, I'll like get more sleep, but as I get used to the schedule, I'll probably just go to bed like 30 minutes later than usual.
I think the new start time is a pretty good idea because it's a good compromise between the 8:15 that everybody wanted. So if it starts at 7:45, we still can go to our after-school activities with being back home on time.
I agree with these start times. Sleeping a little bit more, get you know more rest for sports and stuff like that. But getting out at 2:45, I think that's going to affect a lot of teams' practices and after-school lifts and stuff like that.
Well, I just don't think it's going to make a difference at all because 30 minutes isn't really like going to do anything because once the school year starts, we're going to get used to it and we're still going to be tired and we're going to get out later and nobody's going to be happy about that. So, yeah.
Whether it seems like a dream or a nightmare to you, the start time is another new adjustment being implemented by district leaders in hopes that it will better the days or, in this case, mornings at Mason High School. I'm Anna Knazowitz, NBC News.
The Comet Zone at Mason High School. We have all your spirit needs. From your classic black hole t-shirts to your favorite and most popular comfort tees. Pick up some trendy Comet accessories, required classroom novels, and Mason Comet novelties. The Comet Zone can also create custom gear for your team, club, or organization. The Comet Zone. Get in the zone.
I know you won't be here next year, Douglas, but what do you think about this new start time?
I'm all for it, Simone. What do you think?
I could definitely use the extra 30 minutes in the morning.
You're right. Well, let's actually go over to Riley Johansson to see what other students think about this creative time change.
Let's check it out.
The Mason District has finally announced, after lots of discussion from parents, students, and staff, that it will be changing the high school start time from 7:15 to 7:45 for the 2019-2020 school year. With lots of opinions on how this change will affect our daily high school lives, we asked you, kids in the hall, what are you going to do with the extra 30 minutes? We're starting school 30 minutes later next year, so what are you going to be doing with the 30 minutes?
Like at nighttime?
Yeah. We're starting at 7:45, get out at 2:45. So that extra 30 minutes is totally like means you're going to go about like 7:30, right? Yeah. Like 7:30. You could full out skip dinner and like just go to bed. Imagine how much sleep you would get.
Nighttime, I'll probably still study, but in the morning, I'll probably get a good breakfast in me, some eggs and some bacon.
All right. That sounds good. Sounds like a good plan. You got to eat. What are you going to be doing with the extra 30 minutes that we have next year if they're starting school later?
I'm going to be graduating.
Yeah. That's honestly the best case scenario. What are you guys going to be doing with the extra 30 minutes that we have next year?
Sleeping.
I'm going to sleep in more.
I'm just going to be sleeping more.
Yeah. I'm going to sleep.
Yeah.
Sleeping.
He's going to sleep.
Get up early.
Get up earlier?
Yeah, so I can play Fortnite.
Play 2K with the boys.
But I'm not going to play too much Fortnite.
All right.
Because I need to make myself a burrito.
See, like with 30 minutes, you could have time to think of an answer.
I mean, I guess, but hold on. Let me think.
You could have the burrito and play Fortnite.
And a smoothie. All together.
Full with meal Fortnite. With Fortnite.
Yeah, more of a Minecraft guy.
Minecraft.
Yes.
Gotta hop on the craft.
I play Minecraft.
I don't play Minecraft.
On my phone.
Yeah, I don't play Minecraft.
Minecraft 30, on my phone is the best.
You gotta mine.
Gotta do it. Gotta
30
do it.
Minutes to mine. Get on the mine grind. You could like have a lot more time to think of an answer to a kids in the hall question.
I can make my friendship bracelets.
Friendship bracelets.
Yeah.
Yes. Okay. That's definitely enough time. You have 30 minutes, like 30 whole minutes. That's like two episodes of SpongeBob.
I could watch my TV shows live instead of DVR.
8:30
recorded?
8:30 Central?
8:30, 7:30, 8:30.
That's probably like half an episode of Kardashians. Not Central.
We're
Easter.
Yeah. Hey Siri, what time zone am I in?
Probably stay up later.
I'll probably stay up half an hour later.
Same thing, I'll just stay up an hour later probably.
What if they moved it back like an hour? Would you still like go to bed?
No.
Yeah. I feel that. Do you think it really like makes a difference that much, like
not
half an hour?
Not at all.
I think kids might be safer in the morning when driving to school because it might be lighter.
Okay.
More time for the snow to melt, so less 2-hour delays.
Tragic but true. A lot can be done in 30 minutes. Whether that be sleeping, eating, gaming, or a combination of all three, the changes that this 30-minute change will have on our school day is yet to be seen. Until then, I'm Riley Johansson, MBC News.
Well, you know what January means. Winter sports are in full swing.
That's right. From basketball to swimming and diving to wrestling, MHS is packed with great sports teams and athletes.
Well, let's go to Aiden Crowley to see what's new in Common Athletics. I got that kind of...
What's up, Comic Country? My name's Aiden Crowley, and I'm back to give you guys some updates about what's been going on here for Comet Sports. We're into January, which means we're into the swing of things with winter sports. And something you may not know at the high school is that we do have a new club here, a reinstatement of the ski club. Caroline Wirt took a trip to Indiana to see what's been going on with the new club here at the high school.
Here at MHS, there are countless clubs and after-school activities, and this year, an old favorite is back on the list. Thanks to a few determined freshmen, the ski club is back up and running this year after it took a pause due to increased injuries.
We really value safety, but having a ton of fun while being safe. So everyone's just trying to go out there and have fun and have a great time.
We had to go through a lot of stages, like getting past the school for safety. But after we got past that safety and really trying to nail on the head, being safe but also having fun, we really started to get the ball rolling and got the club made and out here today having fun. So.
Well, we wanted to restart the ski club so that we could get more people to ski and have a fun time out here in Perfect North.
Yeah, we really wanted to spread our passion for what we like. You can ski for 8 years, 20 years, or never ski before. You can come from all different experiences, and it's all about having fun.
So we wanted to give a big, like, special thanks to Miss Allen, Mr. Frigali, and the digital image design people. They all put a lot of work into the club, helping us make logos and getting us past that, like, safety point so that we could, like, snowboard and ski out here and have a fun time.
The new and improved ski club offers a fun environment for all levels. Judging by the atmosphere, I think it's here to stay this time around. I'm Caroline Wirt, MBC Sports.
It's great to see a club that a lot of people were passionate about make a return here at Comet Country after overcoming its challenges. But we do have a swimmer here at the high school who overcame her own challenges to get back into the pool for her senior season. Hasa Malik sat down with Kaylee Flynn about the challenges she faced to get back for her senior season.
Whether it's hitting the gym, doing yoga, or having meal plans, student athletes do many things to keep their body and mind in shape. However, some students are faced with obstacles while trying to achieve their goals. A Mason High School swimmer has had to deal with migraines and a unique method to deal with his excruciating pain.
After years of horrible headaches, Kaylee started her treatment when she was just a sophomore.
I switched to UC Westchester and I see an internal medicine specialist there, and he's really awesome. He has literally changed my life. So we tried medicine with him. I got a spinal tap. And nothing was really working, so he was like, you're probably my youngest patient, but would you be willing to try Botox? It's 40 injections in your face. So it's here, 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 and then on the backside of your head. And it takes about 15 minutes. It hurts a lot, but it is so worth it to be able to be like a normal teenager and not be bounded to my bed and not being able to do anything.
After taking a two-year break, Kaylee rejoined the varsity swim team for her senior year.
Getting Botox and with the help of modern medicine and really caring doctors has made it so that I can go back to school, so that I can go to swimming and just be a normal teenager, and I'm forever grateful that that has been brought back into my life.
Every athlete has to deal with injuries, ailments, and physical limitations that might hinder their performance. Kaylee Flynn is another example of a student athlete achieving despite the challenges that may lie in her path. I'm Hafsa Malik, NBC Sports.
Hello everyone and welcome back to Game Swap. The new year means that we've got some new sports with eager athletes who are ready to take on a challenge. Today I'm here with varsity swimmer Kaylee Flynn and wrestler Doug Farrell, who are going to switch spots and put their knowledge of different sports to the test.
This is 10% luck, 20% skill, 15% concentrated power of will.
What intimidates you the most about swimming? Is it the diving? Is it a backstroke? Is it a freestyle? Or does swimming not really intimidate you at all? Do you think that, hey, I took swimming lessons when I was like six and I'm a pro at it?
Well, the way that I learned how to swim is it's kind of a long story, but swimming doesn't really intimidate me. I mean, the sport, I probably wouldn't be too good at it, but you know, I like to swim in the summer.
All right, well, let's give it a shot.
All right, so first Doug is gonna do a very simple and basic dive. Let's hope he doesn't overcomplicate me.
Sounds good. All right.
All right, so now you're actually gonna get in the water and you're going to swim down and back. It requires a lot of strength. Do you think that you have that manpower and willpower to do so?
Absolutely. It's manpower for a reason. You're looking at the definition of man right here.
Two thousand years later.
Do you think that you're gonna be able to beat Doug by any chance? Like, do you think you could just take him down to the mat easily, or you think you're gonna have to fight for that win?
I'll do whatever it takes, honestly.
I like that kind of an attitude. Let's see. So first up, Doug's gonna do a very simple and basic snap to a front headlock.
Mr. Crying, I'm so scared.
Why are you scared?
Okay, so now that you're kind of loose and warmed up, mm-hmm. I think we're gonna take things to the next level, and okay. we're going to do a lat drop. How does that sound to you?
It sounds like a King's Island ride, honestly. Oh.
Yes.
Oh my God. I think today we learned that, you know, wrestling isn't for everybody. I'm not discluding all girls, but it's not for everybody. And you know what, swimming requires a lot of stamina. That's just something that everybody's gotta work on. But what we do have here today is we do have a very top-notch wrestler and of course a top-notch swimmer. So as always, it was a pleasure. It was a pleasure with the both of you.
We love MBC.
We love MBC.
Thanks for joining us on this edition of Game Swap. Be sure to tweet out to us to let us know who you want to see next. We hope to see you next time. I'm Lana Sacker, MBC Sports.
Props to them for trying out something new.
Yeah, I definitely wouldn't do so hot if I hit the wrestling mat.
Me neither. Well, that's it for this broadcast. Thank you all so much for tuning in.
As always, we're committed to bringing you the news of students making the news.
And we could not do it without our fantastic cast and crew.
From everyone in front of and behind the camera, I'm Simone Scott.
I'm Douglas Arthur-Mensah.